Okay, this is one of the more subtle, difficult parts of the entire process, but one of the most important, arguably the most important, because it's what we're going to be putting on our entity home and spreading around the web. And it's incredibly important that Google understands who you are, what you do, who your audience is from this text. If you're a local business, obviously it needs to understand where you are too. So obviously kind of those three main aspects, who you are, what you do, who your audience is, are the fundamental basis. Then where you are, if that's relevant to your entity. Here's mine from, I actually dug this up, and it's from 2 years ago. I was an SEO consultant in my mind, and I like to say I was a digital marketer, musician, and cartoon blue dog. And I liked talking about the fact that I'm a musician and that I was a blue dog in a cartoon. I thought it was incredibly important, but that's much more to do with my ego than it is to do with actually moving forward today with what I'm doing today. It's dwelling on the past. Now, if somebody wants to know about my past, they presumably will search for my past, or they will look into my description in more detail, as we'll see later on. Then, in fact, my description, the ongoing description here, the extension, talks about search engine optimization, but then keeps going on about musician, cartoon maker. It says I'm playing with bi-acoustic. I've got Kalicube in there. Talk about the blue dog again. I'm bigging myself up with ITV International. All of this is true, and it's all fair enough. And then at the end, you've got this 1989 to 1996. That was 25 years ago. That doesn't help Google understand what I'm doing today and for whom I might be relevant today. What I was doing 25 years ago isn't going to be very helpful in the context of what I'm doing today and the people who are currently generally looking for me. So what we have here is a submit button, as you can see, and it analyzes it. It pings Google's NLP, natural language processing, and it asks what categories can you see. And you can see here it's pretty confused. It's got three different categories, one of which is arts and entertainment. None of them score incredibly highly, under 70%. Yep, I need to rewrite. I really want to get 95%. It means that Google has understood 95% which category I belong to and therefore who my audience is. And then underneath we can see it's got me as a person, that's who I am, 78%, pretty good. But then it's got cartoon, musician, Kalicube, great, but it says other, not company, which is important. Veronique is a person, but it doesn't say which Veronique. Once again, musician, sometimes it duplicates, don't worry about that. Basically, musician is almost 6% because I went on, talked about it much too much. Blue dog, woohoo, 1%. And as you go through, you can see, you know, I've got some good ones, but it's all a big mix. A SaaS, which is a consumer, good, that's great, but it's not very important in this listing. It's got the person, he's a film director, you know, that's not relevant to my life today. And here at the bottom, so you can see the exact text we analyze, because we actually compile little bits to present the text to make sure that we're showing Google's NLP, what Google will truly be seeing when we put the information up online. Now, if I go back here, I can get my new one, which I wrote. And this is the modular system. If I copy paste it in, we'll explain it in a moment. And the idea is, now obviously I've changed to become a digital marketer, digital marketing consultant, in fact. There you go, the subtitle, digital marketing consultant. Now, importantly, the subtitle, we get the little information here. I just want to say what my main activity is. So, don't say digital marketing consultant and musician and blue dog, which is what I would tend to do. Google likes simple, one thing that I do that I'm famous for today. Importantly, I'm not a musician today. Well, I am a musician today, but I don't principally play music and I'm not principally known for music today. Then a short description, executive summary. That's one sentence that really explains with a semantic triple. The beginning of semantic triple is subject, verb, object. Jason Barnard is a digital marketing consultant. And then I go on to explain to people, as opposed to Google specifically, who specializes in brand SERPs and knowledge panels, the brand SERP guy. So I can expand on it. The beginning is just saying to Google, this is what I am. And then I can then add other information both for Google, but specifically and importantly for people. Now, the reason we have this executive summary is some sites, some profiles will only allow a very short text. That's the one you use. Then you have the description extension. You don't repeat this because we can include it systematically. The system includes it in your schema markup. You continue with the description. Now, if the platform you're working on looks like it needs to have this repeated at the beginning, you can just copy paste it. But by default in the system, we just have it like this. Now, the idea here is I've divided what I do today into sections, modulable sections: author, speaker, podcast host, my company, and then my backstory, where I can talk about the blue dog and the yellow koala. I don't even talk about the musician anymore. I perhaps could. And then previous companies founded, because basically I just want to mention them because I know Google understands these two companies as entities. The more entities I can name within the description, obviously without overdoing it, we don't want to spam, and spamming doesn't actually work. It would just confuse the machine even more. But if I can name entities Google has already understood, Google understands that I have a relationship with them. And in this case, I have this founded, which indicates that I founded the companies. That's going to help Google understand correctly that I founded Up to 10 and WTPL Music. Now, why have I done this particular format? Right, imagine that as an H2. In my website, I can put that as an H2 and then have this as a paragraph. Now, semantically, what I'm doing is saying author subheading. So it's very important, with a paragraph afterwards that explains in what way I'm an author and who I write for: Search Metrics, Search Engine Watch, SEMrush, SE Ranking, Wordlift. Then a speaker, that's another subtitle, that's important. And where I speak at, Brighton SEO, PubCon, SMX Series, once again, naming YoastCon entities that I know Google has understood, that will help it to understand in what context I am a speaker and with which entities I am related within that context, and so on and so forth. Now, the reason we've done it in this modular fashion is twofold. Number one is a lot of these profiles don't allow you this amount of text. So in fact, what you can do is just cut out, for example, on some, if I've got too much, I can just cut that out and just use this part, and so on and so forth. So it allows me to change the text, the length of the text, without changing the content, without going back and arguing with people about what it is we need to write if this was a company rather than myself. That's reason number one. Reason number two is, I'm on a platform, for example, Muckrack, I would definitely leave author. I would never cut that, but I might cut the company. If I was on a platform such as Crunchbase, I would take the company and I would put it first. Because in the context of Crunchbase, the company is more important than the authorship. So the modular system allows us, A, to remove anything that isn't pertinent for a particular platform, B, shorten it if necessary, C, reorder things in order of priority for the audience we're addressing. This isn't for Google. It's saying, if I'm on Crunchbase, I would be more interested in Jason Barnard's companies than his authorship. Whereas if I'm on Muckrack, I would be more interested in his authorship than his company. So I can just do that. And what will then happen is that if you do that across all your different profiles, Google will see these chunks in multiple places. So if you have 50 profiles, it will see each of these chunks anything from 30 to 50 times. It doesn't need to see every chunk every time. It needs to see every chunk in the right context every time. And it's logical for the machine that authorship on Muckrack is first and has the most importance. And that's also very important, is the order is very important. The machine reads from top to bottom, most important to least important, which is why backstory goes right at the bottom. If somebody's interested in my backstory, they will read the whole bio and find that chunk and find out that I was a blue dog. Now, if I click here, this is the old score still. I click, saves it to the system each time. With 99% in one category, you can have two categories, that's not a problem, but the main category needs to be 95% or over, preferably at least 70%. Anything less than 70%, Google simply has not understood and will not understand, and you're just going to create more ambiguity. So 99%, pretty good score. We've got Jason Barnard, the person, is 71%. Basically, what that says is that this text is 71% focused on Jason Barnard, the person. I'm a founder, that's great. I'm a person who's a founder, that's great. Panels, not necessarily terribly interesting as a concept. It hasn't seen that knowledge and panel goes together. That isn't a big deal, don't freak out about that. Brand, organization, that's helpful to me, although not 100% accurate. Speaker as a person, that's great. SERP guy, consumer good, that's a bit strange. Once again, don't obsess about the details. That isn't a big deal. If it misunderstood slightly there, it hasn't seen that I'm the brand SERP guy. Brand SERPs, it has understood. And the reason that it's having trouble with that is because brand SERPs is a new concept that I'm kind of pushing to fore. A year ago, nobody was really talking about it. Now we are talking about it. If I look up Kalicube, for example, here, well, that's Kalicube Tuesdays. We see at the bottom, brand SERP. Google is starting to understand it's a related search and it's an entity, as we can see in images. I would imagine brand SERP will come up here somewhere. Well, we've got brand and SERP separately, but if I search for brand SERP, and looking up in images is a really useful way to see what entities Google has understood. So it isn't really up to scratch with brand SERP, but it does recognize that I'm the most associated entity with the idea of brand SERPs. And SE ranking as well. That's only because I would imagine I've written a couple of articles for them. So guests, marketing, publication. I mean, this is a much, 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 much better list. A series is a work of art. I like that. A work of art isn't necessarily the Mona Lisa. A work of art is something somebody has created, which can be a TV series, a podcast series, a website is a work of art, interestingly enough. And as we go through this list, one thing we do notice is the capital letters make a big difference. It sees guests as a person correctly, and others as a person, author as a person, but that capital letter at the beginning, especially of a name like Jason Barnard, gives it that clue. It's proper nouns, it's using the rules of the English language or any language correctly. Proper nouns, entities, have capital letters at the start of each word. So be careful to use that. Don't use all caps. If you use all caps, it will immediately lose this. So you can go through that list. I mean, we've got a lot more entities here. We've got 61 instead of 27. Once you get down the bottom here, they're not things that are particularly important to the text. Obviously, these three companies, work of art, it thinks this is a piece of music, but these three aren't very important because they're right at the bottom of the text. These aren't important for us or for Google necessarily. It doesn't matter that it mentions kids down here. So, and I've got these entities here, obviously very important from my perspective professionally. Google has seen that there are people. We're looking at a pretty good understanding, a pretty good list. It's balanced. It's majoritarily about Jason Barnard. Google has understood that, and that's absolutely fine. So once I've submitted that, I would then go on here to submit this, the fundamental facts. Obviously, the description doesn't exist on its own. On your entity home, you will have that plus these fundamental facts. The two together really make for some great understanding, especially if you fill in all the information. And a quick note here, the job title CEO at Kalicube is not the same necessarily as the subtitle, although it can be. For example, if my principal occupation was CEO at Kalicube, I could have them in both places, subtitle and job title. But the one I want in the knowledge panel is this one. So if I wrote CEO of Kalicube, I would be aiming to have CEO of Kalicube as the subtitle in my knowledge panel. So that slight confusion is something that I think people get stuck with. The job title is the job title today. Now, the point here is the job title is very temporary. I could change job title tomorrow. I could be promoted if I was a CMO, for example. Whereas what I am fundamentally, i.e. digital marketing consultant, will change much less often. Most people will not change that subtitle over their entire life span. They will be a writer from beginning to end, or a digital marketing consultant, or whatever it might be. And for those who do change, Google has a great deal of problems understanding it. That will tend to be something that takes special care and attention. As you can see on my knowledge panel, it says British musician, and I'm having quite a lot of trouble changing it because of all the references to me as a musician from my history, my previous life 30 years ago as a musician. And the reason for that is actually because of the fan-driven human curated content that is structured on Wikidata, Discogs, Music Brains, all of these platforms that Google is using, Spotify as well, that Google is using for information to start understanding, to get its understanding of the world, its knowledge graph started. So things like musician, entertainer, sports person are going to tend to dominate, at least in the short term, and they're quite difficult to change. So this information, alongside that description, is going to give Google an incredibly good understanding of who I am, exactly what I do, and who my audience is. And as you can see here on this, when I click submit, it's not very obvious, but we can see that the information is updated. Then I can go and get my schema markup, and that includes this description here that I just wrote. And as you can see, we have a full stop at the end of every sentence. Author, colon, full stop. Speaker, colon. That's a kind of pseudo H2, because a lot of platforms don't allow you to put H2s, and that colon is a pseudo H2. It helps Google to separate the text and say, okay, this is slightly separate from the rest. How well it works, obviously debatable. I'm pretty convinced that it's pretty effective. Thank you.